What's up, guys? TKF here again, bringing you another Domination gameplay. This one is going to be on the map Havana. We're going to use Silence Galil here with Hardline, Sleight of Hand Pro, and Hacker. Haven't got around to Pro in those perks yet, this is one of my other accounts. This is Mr. Carrot 45. I guess you guys can feel free to add me if I have space on my list. But the reason why I have like 4 or 5 accounts is because all of my friends' lists are currently full. So I guess, you know, I could delete some people that are inactive if that's what you guys want. But anyway, this gameplay is a pretty fast-paced one. It's a pretty rush-orientated gameplay. I just want to explain to you guys the reason behind the silencer before we get into this. Normally, I don't run silencer. It's really not within my my playstyle, I guess. It's just that I was in a lobby with my friend Nick, or Tectoas, and we were facing a lot of Ghost Pros, Second Chance, Silence Gun users, and it was really getting to me, and I kind of figured, you know what, I'm going to crack. I'm just going to start using a silencer, see how well I can use it. And it helps, man. I'm in their spawns, and they just haven't got a clue where I am. It's absolutely amazing. You stay off the minimap. I strongly recommend a silencer. I mean, you kind of have to have, you know, the decent ability to be able to get in their spawn and deal with numerous enemies anyway. But if you got that down, you can do that. Try doing it with a silencer. You may seem to think that, you know, you're losing a lot of damage and stuff, but really it doesn't matter, because most of the time you'll be attacking them from the back or the side anyway, seeing as, you know, you're pretty much a ghost, even without using the perk ghost. But anyway, other than that, the topic for this commentary is going to be, first off, my HD PVR. So as you guys can tell by the graphics of this, or the quality of this video, it's not a HD PVR. Now, I want to explain to you guys why that is before we get into this video. Now, I had a party a few days ago, and I had my my really nice shiny blue and green HD PVR. I had custom LEDs on it, and that was just lying on my bedroom floor next to my PS3 and my computer, as it always is. Had a few friends over, had a few drinks, and it got a little bit leery, and some beer managed to find its way onto my PVR. So no more PVR. Now, as much as this upset me, I've rang up a load of electrical companies asking them if they can fix it. I've just given it to this guy, like Sweeps something, I don't know. I've just given it to them to get it repaired. And they called me back yesterday and gave me the horrible news that my PVR is broken. So I do not have access to HD recording equipment at the moment, which is really sad, because now I'm going to have to spend another 200 bucks on HD PVR. I promise you guys I'll do it. I have no problem spending money on my channel for you guys. I just went out and purchased this very lovely blue snowball, which I'm speaking into right now. That cost me 70 quid, which is the equivalent to around about 100 bucks, which was, that was pricey. But it's all worth it for you guys, so I went ahead and did that anyway. But the real topic of this commentary is going to be Modern Warfare 3. I know loads of you guys are going to be excited for this. I recently went out and pre-ordered Modern Warfare 3 at my local game shop up in the galleries. I live in Bristol. So I've got that done. I'm going to go up there and pick it up on midnight release. I will probably be one of the very first people to have Modern Warfare 3 content on my channel. Other than those guys that, again, a few days early, of course, you know, the big YouTubers. Not really too sure who's getting it early, but, you know, we'll see. But I'm certainly getting mine midnight, and as soon as I get that, I'll be home. I'll be going straight online, getting you guys some gameplay ASAP. I want to put up loads of tips and trick videos. I want to do map tutorials. I want to get you guys learning the spawns as quick as possible. I mean, in most Call of Duty games, the spawns are pretty stereotypical, you know. As soon as you spawn in on that first game, you take note of where you are, and you're most likely to spawn in and around that area. And then pretty much you just know the other spawn as soon as you play a second round, if it's Demolition or Search and Destroy, for example. Or if not, then you know, you pretty much get spawn flips in Domination all the time, as you can see by this gameplay. So you'll be able to pick up the spawns pretty quickly. Just the reason for me wanting to do a kind of like a topic, or, you know, tricks, tips kind of video for a map, would just be so I could show you guys the choke points of the spawn, the main spawn areas, you know, places to stay clear of. I want you guys to get a really good understanding of this game so that you can rank up and progress through it as fast as possible. I mean, I know it's not all about going through it fast as possible, but, you know, the quicker you go through it, the quicker you get the stuff you want to get. I mean, personally, at the moment, I am slaving in Call of Duty Modern Warfare to try and prestige so that I can get my 4th prestige token, I think. I've prestiged in Modern Warfare 2, prestiged in Black Ops, prestiged in Call of Duty World at War. So the only one I haven't really prestiged in that I have played is Call of Duty 4, so I need to get that done. It's currently double XP across the franchise. Every Call of Duty game has double XP. That is my understanding. Robert Bowling did confirm that. He said it was across the entire franchise, so what a better time to prestige on games than now. You might as well do it, because you're not going to get double XP on COD 4 ever again, probably. So it's probably good that you do that. For you guys that are unfamiliar about what I'm talking about, the Prestige tokens are specific to the Prestige shop, which is a new feature they're adding into Modern Warfare 3, and it allows the player to basically gain better control over what they get when they Prestige. Now, normally you guys know when you Prestige, you don't actually get much. You get the extra custom class every other Prestige or so, and you unlock, you know, more titles and more emblems if we're talking about an Infinity Ward game. So what's different about Modern Warfare 3? Well, I think you guys have already had a video on the Prestige shop, but just to recap, basically, once you Prestige, you get a Prestige token. You also get a Prestige token for Prestiging in previous Call of Duty games, such as Modern Warfare, Modern Warfare 2, World at War. You know, you just get Prestige tokens for those. Now, Prestige tokens buy you a certain amount of, I don't know, well, they buy you something new in the Prestige shop, so... Say, for example, I mean, I know it's not, it's been confirmed, I think it's been confirmed that the intervention's not in Modern Warfare 3 anymore, but there was a rumor going around saying it was at level 40 that you get it. So let's just say, for the sake of this commentary, that you unlock the intervention at level 40. Now, I'm already going to have 4 prestige tokens when I go onto the game, but there is this slight little rumor that apparently you have to prestige to use the prestige shop. That would make sense, but anyway, say I've prestiged once. I want to get the intervention at level 40, but I don't want to wait that long. So I can use one of my prestige tokens in the prestige shop, and that will let me buy the intervention and have it for the whole prestige. Not only that, Robert Bolin did say on Twitter, and he did tweet this, so it is there for evidence, that he did say that if you unlock a weapon before it can be unlocked via prestige token, you actually get that weapon for the rest of your prestiges. It's like when you start on Black Ops, you get the MP5K. You will get that with the weapon that you buy with the prestige token. I mean, what's the point in getting something from a prestige token if you need to get it again next prestige? You just end up spending all your tokens on the same thing. I mean, you can already unlock different custom classes, you can unlock weapons earlier, you can unlock double XP for 2 hours, and if you use that on double XP, you actually get quad XP. Another thing that was definitely confirmed, written in stone, quote unquote, on Twitter, by Robert Bowling. So you can get quad XP if you so wish. Personally, I think I'll be using those from level 75 to level 80, seeing as those are the ones that drag the most. You can certainly unlock a lot more than just this in the Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 Prestige Shop. I'm really looking forward to seeing what else I can unlock. I know there are several videos on it, but I really don't want to ruin the experience just yet. I really want to see what I can get for myself. So, if I haven't mentioned it already, I did pre-order the Hardened Edition of Modern Warfare 3, so that means I will be getting a year subscription free to Call of Duty Elite, which means I'll be able to look at my analytics and look at all of my stats in detail and be able to get all of that up and share and compare online, I guess. Be able to do all of that. Not only that, but I get all the map packs free for a year. And personally, I really don't see Infinity Ward or Sledgehammer releasing any more maps after a year. So it seems like a good deal to me, I guess. But that will be the end, guys. I hope you enjoyed. It was a 49-6 gameplay. Check out my channel if you want to see some more stuff from me. Other than that, I'm TKF, and I'll see you guys later. Deuces.